Hello. In this video, we'll demonstrate two ways to run an IDE workstation in Google Cloud. In both of these cases, we'll access and use the IDE via any normal web browser like Chrome or Firefox. We can see the first option if I click this button in the top right here. This opens up a Cloud Shell terminal and automatically authenticates with Google Cloud using our user account. To demonstrate that authentication, I can see if a Kubernetes cluster listing command generates an error, which it does not. We can expand the terminal capabilities into a full-blown IDE editor by clicking on Open Editor and Open a New Window. Now we have a nice IDE with file editing capabilities as well as terminals. As far as the benefits, this approach is both free and super easy to use. Two button clicks and we have an IDE running. That said, the simplicity also means a lack of configurability. For example, we don't have the ability to configure machine sizes. We're also stuck with this particular IDE style, which is pretty similar to VS Code. At the IDE settings level, we do have some configurability, like color theme selection. However, it doesn't go much deeper than that. Let's move along to the other approach for cloud-based IDEs, which is aptly named Cloud Workstations in Google Cloud. To save some time in the demonstration, I already set up a cluster. However, we can walk through the creation form. Note that the cluster is essentially a control plane for managing our workstations. We can hook this up to a VPC network and configure other network settings. There are some other configuration like resource tracking with labels. However, the main parts here are essentially the name, region, and VPC. Think of a cluster as a landing zone or target for workstations. Also keep in mind that the cluster carries a cost, even if it is not running any workstations. Let's now move on to creating a configuration. We'll give the configuration a name and select our cluster from earlier. Then we'll need to check and potentially modify settings around the basic machine and environment tabs. This setting here is really important. If we have Quick Start workstations enabled, then we'll be continually paying for a set of workstations on an ongoing basis, even if we're not using them. Essentially, this keeps the workstations warm and ready for quick access use. If we disable this setting, it's typically going to mean a significantly lower monthly cost, since most people spend only a minority of their 720 hours per month in an IDE. Again, though, that means we'll have no workstations warm and we'll need to wait a while before any IDE session. Notice that, in either case, we need to set a sleep duration. The quick start setting affects wake speed. It doesn't mean our workstations aren't sleeping at all. Let's continue on with the configuration and note that we have control over machine types. So this is a big differentiator with cloud workstations. We can provision and use significantly more compute and memory as compared to Cloud Shell IDE. There are a number of additional advanced configurations here, focused largely on security and networking. We can wrap up by looking at the environment customization, which is how we specify what sort of IDE we'd like. Code OSS is very similar to Cloud Shell IDE, but we have a number of other options here. For example, we can run the JetBrains IDEs. After picking an option, we can configure the associated storage and advanced container options. If we need even more customization, we can use a custom container image for our workstations. Those could include, for example, some special libraries that we use for our personal development work or company projects. Unlike Cloud Shell IDE, these configurations can be reused across different users, so feel free to reuse, share, and standardize. Let's go ahead and create a pretty default configuration, and then we'll create a workstation from that configuration. Note that in workstations, you can see any workstations that you have permission to see, whereas only your own workstation will show up in My Workstations. You can create a workstation from either page. The workstation creation itself is quite straightforward, once we already have that configuration, since that's where we'll specify most of the IDE details. If we refresh the page here, we'll see our workstation booting up. Now that our workstation has started, we can launch it. When we use that base image, things are going to look pretty similar to the Cloud Shell IDE. Again, we get a terminal, a file editor, and can make customizations to the workstation. So the obvious question here is, where would you want to use each of these two cases? The Cloud Shell IDE is really nice for getting started or for the quick invocation of ad hoc gcloud commands. The Cloud Workstations capabilities are effectively a superset of the Cloud Shell IDE. This approach provides a lot more configurability, like the choice of machine size and IDE vendor. If you need control over those details, you'll certainly want to use the Cloud Workstations. Also, this option enables sharing configurations across users or teams, so company or team collaboration often encourages Cloud Workstations use. That all said, the Cloud Workstation advantages do come at a cost. The active workstations incur costs, but the clusters and quick start workstations also contribute to your monthly bill. In contrast, the Cloud Shell IDE is completely free. At this point, I think we've covered the high points, so we'll wrap up this video. We hope that this quick cloud-based IDE introduction was helpful, and we'll keep an eye on the comments section for any questions or concerns. Thank you for watching.